My dear student, myself Kamran Rashid. I am working as an assistant professor in the Department of Mechanical Engineering in Integral University, Lucknow. I have completed my B.Tech in Mechanical Engineering and I have completed my M.Tech from Computer Aided Design from Harcourt Butler Technological Institute, Kanpur. Teaching gives me an opportunity to be a lifelong learner. Teaching is a passion for me because of whatever I studied, whatever I learned from different sources, whatever I gained from my experience, I can share with young people, the people who are going to be make their future. So teaching gives me an opportunity to work with young people, and one of the best thing is this, I feel very young to work with young people. So teaching is more than a job for me. Today I am going to discuss a topic
from chapter 9, physics, mechanical properties of solids.
Mechanical properties of solids are very interesting topics in which we can discuss different types of properties related with the solids. Properties like elasticity, plasticity, properties like resilience, properties like hardness, toughness, these are the some important properties related to the properties of solid. So today I am going to discuss one of the very interesting concept of stress and strain curve. The stress and strain curve is a very important topic and very interesting topic. So today I am going to discuss topic related to the stress and strain curve. Here I am going to draw a curve, stress, and this on x-axis there is strain and on y-axis there is stress. Stress is denoted by sigma and strain is normally denoted by small e. So this stress and strain curve is for the ductile material. This stress and strain curve is for the ductile material. So, according to the stress strain curve for ductile material, from O to A, from this point to this point, the stress is directly proportional to strain. We can say that the stress is directly proportional to strain from O to A. And this is the Hooke's law. According to the Hooke's law, within the limit of elasticity, the stress is directly proportional to strain. And for defining the elasticity, or we can say the elasticity is the limit at which when we remove the external load, the material will get its original shape. It will recover the original shape. So from O to A, from point O to from point A, the region is known as limit of elasticity from point O to A. That means from point O to A, at the point A, when we remove the external load, the material will get its original shape again. It regains its original shape from point A to B. From point A to B, the curve is not linear. Curve is not linear. In this section, Hooke's law is not valid. So, stress is not directly proportional. So in the region of A to B, stress is not directly proportional, but elasticity remains. In this section, if at point B we remove the load, the material will regain its original shape. So we can say that at B, elasticity, limit of elasticity is not exist, but the material can regain its original shape if we remove the external load. From B to C, and beyond point B, the plastic zone starts. Beyond point B, from this point, this whole region is known as plastic zone. Beyond point B, the whole region is known as plastic zone. In this region, if we remove the load, the material will not regain its original shape, it's permanently deformed. So the point C, point D, point E, all these points are lying in the plastic zone. C and D point C and point D, if we are talking about the point C and point D, so the point C is known as upper yield point, and point D is known as lower yield point. Point E is known as ultimate stress point, and point F is known as failure point. So these are the few points which are achieved in the stress strain curve. So we discuss about all these points. The meaning of yielding is when the material changes its phase from elastic to plastic. Before the point B, the material is in elastic phase, but beyond the point B, material is in plastic state. So this is the transition phase in which the material changes its phase from elastic to plastic. So the point C and point D are known as upper yield point and lower yield point. At upper yield point, we can see from the graph, it is a conceptual point, the value of stress, suppose that is sigma C, and at lower yield point, the value of stress, suppose that sigma T. But with respect to these values of stresses, the value of strain is different. If we see from the graph at point D, where the value of stress is less, but the value of strain is high as compared to point C. So we can say that at point D, the value of stress level is low, but the strain can be increased, or the value of strain is high as compared to point C. So by applying less amount of stress at the point D, we can get the more deformation as compared to point C. And then after this point, the curve suddenly moves up, and at the top point we get the point E. This is the upper stress level, and this is known as ultimate stress point. And after that point, the material get fail or material get fracture. So this is the stress strain curve by which we can analyze the properties of material, or by which we can find out the different types, different points where the material can be changes its phases. So from A to, or from O to A within elastic limit, and from O to B, this is the elastic zone. Beyond the B, the plastic zone is start, and C and D are the upper yield and lower yield point. Capital E, this point is known as ultimate stress point. This is the maximum stress level in the elongation test, and after that material gets failed. So this is the stress strain curve in a very short manner. So I think this is a very knowledgeable video. So thank you, friends.